get one or two, and then we wipe them out. Five guys open up on fire and knock these radical Islamic assholes out, you know? That's what I'm thinking. What do you think?
Oh, boy.
Come on. It's like it's about time you start talking the talk. It's what you got to do in this country. It's the Old West.
I have so many ways to go with this.
Please, Scott St. James. We haven't even gotten to the fun news of the day.
For openers.
Yes.
You see, I've been sick over what's been happening several months ago, or several years ago, about Americans having their heads chopped off.
Exactly.
By these people that...
these terrorist organizations.
Yeah, are supposed to be people who love God or something, and, you know, they're religious people. But I've had this attitude with these people. Over, I've kept my mouth shut, but that's over with, because after a while you have to accept the fact that people that we don't understand, and in more cases than not, we don't really want to know, because what we've learned so far isn't good. Are there some good people there? There probably are, but there's just too many of those folks out there are doing things to us, and after a while, we are the United States of America. We are the biggest, baddest country in the world. If we need to be, if we need to be in a big war, I have a big problem with our people going there. But instead, we've been standing aside while all these people are doing to our soldiers, our people, and letting it go. This thing that just happened in San Bernardino right now, I'm tired of this stuff. I'm ready to go down there and just say, hey, you, bang, you, bang, you, bang.
You're with me on
tired
this.
Of this
You're
stuff.
You're with me on
I'm
this.
I'm flat out tired of it.
All right, we'll talk more about this here on the show. I'm with you. Scott St. James is sounding off. I've sounded off. You know, when I was in the Czech Republic, they showed pictures in our little press group, and they were saying, well, after World War II, they shipped all the Germans out of the Czech Republic. Well, you think after the Germans came in and killed all the Jews, you don't think you'd want to get rid of the Germans and throw them back into Germany?
So.
Time to clear out these radical Islamic Muslims and throw them back where they belong in the desert and sit there and burn themselves up. That's all I got to say.
Good example.
Strip them out. I'll take
great
the CRN
example.
Van and
great
pull them up
example.
And drive them across the
great
border.
Great example, my pal.
Kid, let me paint you a picture. Tuesday night, your cog belt goes bust. Who will help you get what you need fast? Without the hoops, hurdles, or headaches? Granger, that's who. I love Granger. They got a wide variety of products and solutions. Granger makes it easy to get everything we need and answers for when we're not sure what the answer is. Now, kid, let me paint you another picture. It looks like a mop, a basement bathroom, and you all over it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com or stop by. Granger. For the ones who get it done.
Get better than Black Friday deals at Lumber Liquidators Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Every floor in stock is on sale, including all pre-finished hardwood on sale from an unheard of 89 cents. All wood look tile on sale from 79 cents. All laminate and vinyl flooring on sale from an unbeatable 39 cents. Plus, save on bamboo, tools, installation, and more deals in your local store. And pay no interest till 2018. Who said Black Friday was the only day to save? Get deals all week at the Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Going on now. Visit Lumber Liquidators. .com to find a store near you.
DM Show nationwide, coast to coast, CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm on the Trump bandwagon, the Ted Cruz bandwagon. I'm on the Rubio bandwagon, the Chris Christie, whoever, the Huckabee, whoever's going to stand up here and say it's time for us to get tough and take care of our country and protect our own and quit worrying about whether we got to let these people in. This ball-headed goofball, I got to tell you, this guy we have for president right now, he's got the grayest cue-ballish head ever. He's always had that rounded head with that really low crop, and the crop has turned totally gray because this guy will not get tough and we got to let the Syrians in. If we allow this idiot in the White House to allow Syrians in without having the legislature take the vote on it, we're absolutely nuts in this country. It's time for checks and balances. There's a president, there's the House, there's the Senate, and there's the Supreme Court, and start running this country like it should be and throw this idiot with his executive orders right in the old ash can where he belongs with these things. I'm tired of this crap.
Okay,
I'm tired of his executive orders.
I'm going to take it further than that. What this president is doing now as far as letting people in, I've never been behind that, but he's not the only one. The presidents before that were letting them in.
Everybody's been soft. It's time to toughen it up.
Yeah, and so that's it. Whoever our next president is, and whoever it is, we have some interesting people who are, you know, trying to be our next president. And I just hope that whoever that is, who ends up getting elected, is a person who is basically going to put his foot, or, you know, hand down on the table and say, all right,
here's the line.
It's a new deal now. As far as all these new people coming in here and just coming in here because we're letting them in, we are stopping that right now. Right now. Bang, bang, bang. You have got to be able to come here under ways that we're letting you be that way for the last, 40 years or something like that? Probably longer than that.
Turn on the other cheek, and I'm tired of this crap about that no one else in America will do the jobs except this group will do them. That's total BS.
Yeah.
If you're out of work and you need to get work, you'll do whatever job you got to do to make a living.
But as far as people coming in here who do have no business coming here without, you know, letting us know that you're a decent citizen. We don't know any of that stuff. We just let them in.
Like everybody that came in this country legally had to go through a series of checks and balances over a period of time, tests, that kind of thing. And to say stupid things like the restaurant business is going to fall apart if we don't have illegal immigrants, that is a crock of BS. Because I'll tell you what, the restaurant business will fall apart because the government's going to raise the minimum wage or tell you got to put the salt items on the menu. The government will destroy the restaurant business like they destroy everything. It's time to downsize this government, run it like a private business, and start making a profit on everything. And that's it. I agree with Trump when he says we got to take care of our own energy and start doing fracking or whatever on our soil. Just do it. You know what? Look and take care of the environment and take a look at that and make sure that you do the checks and balances for that. But let's just start being energy sufficient on our own and independent of any other country.
Back when I wrote a blog that I wrote for 6 years. And you did.
You used to have a great blog. Yeah. Scott St. James, by the way, and Michael Horn with you here on the PM show.
During that time there, that I often said, anybody wants to know what I think? America first.
America first.
And I used to mention that a lot. And what I wish now is that I wish the people who are elected take that position.
I'm with you.
America first, because they're not doing that now. We were just talking about that in the last couple of minutes ago. 30, 40, maybe 50 years ago. I don't know. It's a long time, though. It's not just this president. It's all of them. All of them, just letting them do it. We've got to stop that. It's got to be America first, because
we've had some good presidents.
Had some good presidents, but they've let that go.
Tear down this wall, do some things.
But they're also letting people in.
I'm with you.
We just have to do that. We have to do that.
Have to reassess it. Moratorium. Nobody in until we figure out how we're going to handle it. That's all I say.
I grant the fact that most of these presidents have been nice guys and everything else. I'll go with that. But. The new guys or women, whatever, you've just got to come in now, folks. It's got to be a new deal. America first, folks. That's all. All you got to do is remember two words, please. America first.
Scott St. James with you here. Lots of stuff to talk about this week, and we'll try and get to the lighter side. But this just really ticked me off because you have this terrorist attack, this first ISIS attack in the United States, and it happens not too far from our broadcast center, 60 miles away just about in San Bernardino. You go out there to the casinos and stuff. You're on your way out there, right?
Right.
It's right there, and it's and this guy goes ahead and because he's chasing some skirt, she goes ahead and turns him into some. Come on, how feeble brained can you be to actually suit up and get assault weapons and go in there and kill innocent people? What kind of a piece of dirt are you? What kind of scumbag piece of human excrement are you that you think that way? And if you think you're doing these great things for whatever you believe in, you got to screw loose. That's all I got to say. Time for them to go and do some heavy shock therapy on you to take your brain and fry it outside your rear end. That's what I say. Throw it right out the backside. I'm done with this.
Amen, I'm done with amen, this crap. Amen, amen. I'm with you. I'm bowing down right now.
That's what I'm telling you. And I think that's why Trump is up in the polls, and that's why I think Ted Cruz is up in the polls, and that's why Ben Carson is down now, because he's not that tough on protecting the country. And that's why the Democrats are down in the dumpsters right now, because they've been soft on this. They won't even call a terrorist. I mean, come on.
It's crazy.
Get off the crappy chair you're sitting on and start realizing what's going around. Just like, this is like President Carter days. You know, you're very smart and you're very intelligent, and you sit there and talk into your beard and you say absolutely nothing. You ever listen to Obama talk? He says absolutely nothing. He just goes ahead and throws fancy words out. He's, you know, very carefully chooses his words. And when you get all through, you scratch your head and go, what did he just say? He basically says, I'm going to do nothing about this. That's what he says every time. He's got to always make sure, and you never find out when he's ever sure about anything. It's a weak-willed guy. Weak. Namby-pamby. You know, it's once again the country wanted to say, let's get our first black president. It'll be good for the country. Yeah, maybe it'll be so. Why didn't we elect a president that was smart and intelligent and could really handle things and uphold the American traditions instead of just getting the first guy of color in there? You know, we had a Mayor Tom Bradley in this town of L.A. that did great things for Los Angeles for four terms. There's a great elected black official right there. Tom Bradley. Let's talk about the good guys that are out there instead of this weak-willed namby-pamby.
All right.
But I'm done with this guy. I'm done with his BS.
That's okay, but
he's had four Secretary of Defenses. What does that tell you? What president has never happened in this country? Nobody can work with the guy.
If he was the only one doing this, this would be real easy, but he's not.
The worst. He is the worst at doing this. You know, he's the worst. Other presidents have tried to make a stand. This guy is weak
because of his. Not enough.
Not doing enough.
Not enough. None of them. None of them.
Well, it may change now. It may change now.
That's the kind of person we have to have. We have to, because...
Tell me about it. Come on.
After all this stuff about, you know, what we've experienced here over the last few months and years, you know, our people are getting their heads taken off with big things that just knocks their heads off. We've never experienced that. And it's been going back for 50, 60, 70 years. And so now, whoever gets elected this time, now put the fist down and say, we are the United States of America. It's a new deal, folks. It hasn't been this way for quite a while. Quite a while. Not just in the last 8 years. In the last maybe 60 or 80 years. We want to change it. We need to change it now. We want no more Americans getting their necks sliced apart and all the rest. We got to stop that stuff.
Especially on our soil. Not in our country, right?
Exactly.
The line has been drawn.
America first.
Straight ahead, we continue here, the PM Show, Weekend Edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, along with this famous Scott St. James.
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach. Footsteps from room to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach. 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
Do you have really pure water? Maybe not if you're drinking bottled water. Bottled water has some dirty little secrets. Plastic bottles come from oil products. The 5-gallon polycarbonate jugs contain bisphenol A, a synthetic estrogen that has raised health concerns. Bottled water dispensers quickly develop algae and bacteria and should be sanitized regularly. Have you ever cleaned your water dispenser? Are you drinking water containing algae and bacteria and synthetic estrogen? Now the good news. Pure Water Science can replace that dirty, outdated bottled water cooler with a high-tech water purification system. system. The Pure Water Science System features a stainless steel tank that constantly monitors water quality to guarantee your water is pure. It alerts you when service or filter changes are needed. Multi-stage purification removes organic and inorganic contaminants, and the patented self-sanitizing feature eliminates algae and bacteria while adding oxygen to your water. It costs less than bottled water without the bottled water hassle. No more bottles to lift. Just sanitize delicious water, hot or cold, from Pure Water Science. Call 818-502-4191. 818-502-4191.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
Welcome back here to the PM Show Weekend Edition, CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, along with the Hammer, famed broadcast professional Robert W. Morgan, whom Scott St. James worked with for many years. Referred to you, Scott St. James, as the jammer with a hammer, right?
That is correct.
And we can hear it when you get going here on the show. So Jerry Seinfeld is in the news. He's going to do a stand-up in residence at the New York City's Beacon Theater. Have you heard about this? He's going to take up residency in New York's Beacon Theater.
Yeah, I did hear. Go ahead. Tell us all about
that. He'll perform a monthly show entitled Jerry Seinfeld, The Homestand. It's going to be a stand-up series. Going to be presented by the Madison Square Garden Company. Starts the first show on January 7th and continues through the spring. And he's a renowned New Yorker whose brand of comedy is rooted in the Big Apple. A Madison Square Garden Company chairman, James Dolan, from Dolan and Cablevision, said he's honored to host Seinfeld in a stand-up series at the Beacon. There's six show dates so far next year, and I mentioned January 7th, February 18th, March 2nd, April 14th, May 5th, and June 8th. All tickets will go on sale starting December 7th at 10 a.m. We should try to go.
Well, I believe that place would be packed every night.
Pamela Anderson is going to be in the last Playboy nude issue. You've heard about this, haven't you? The Playboy is just going to have articles and no more nude photographs.
I got it more than a month ago.
Unbelievable. This is what the magazine was all about.
I got this magazine more than a month ago.
The Pamela Anderson one?
Yeah.
She's going to be the last person to pro. It's fitting. She's beautiful. She's lovely. She's had a great career.
Yep.
She was in Playboy many times. I heard some millennial talking about this
18
today.
18 times, I think.
Obviously not being very nice to females, and you should be nice to the lovely Pamela Anderson.
Well, she was interviewed with a lot of rock stars, though.
There's been a lot of videos with her.
Yeah.
She's going to pose nude for Playboy magazine, closing a more than 60 year tradition that has seen the women ranging from Madonna to Kim Kardashian, Cindy Crawford, Marilyn Monroe strip off in the publication. Playboy magazine said on Thursday that she's going to be featured on the cover for the January-February 2016 edition that will hit newsstands December 11th. You have a copy of this before?
Yeah, I do.
How do you? You've got some pull there at the mansion, don't you? You and Fred Dreyer.
Well,
what are they going to have? Poetry inside this magazine now? And Playboy, what's it going to be about? It's going to be like, you know, what's going to be in it?
They're not what they used to be, that's all.
You think?
I think they're close to closing down.
Poor old Hugh Hefner got sold the bill of goods when he sold the company to whoever's running it now.
Yeah.
And obviously he gets to stay in the mansion, but when he goes and he's getting up there, that's going to be over.
I don't think it's going to last long.
He's been a hell of a run holding it together. Yeah.
It's been a hell of a run.
Yeah, Hugh Hefner announced in October that it would stop publishing nude photos of women, saying they'd become outdated due to the plethora of free pornography on the internet. Well, I think sometimes you want a magazine. Tomas, you've always told me that. You like something to hold and, you know, frame, that sort of a thing. Should take care of people like Tomas. And he's, you know, he does a great impression of Johnny Mathis.
I was just thinking the same thing. Yeah. He should go on over there and sing for him.
Playboy's circulation dropped from about 5.6 million in 1975 to around 800,000 in recent years. You still got your subscription, Tomas? You still get the complimentary? No? Tomas is one of those guys where, you know, sometimes in the media you get some complimentary issues. That's the one thing I always saw in his mailbox.
That's a
Playboy issue.
That's a big thing you put up there with it. Was it Jesus?
Which fell from 5.6 million circulation in 75
to
800,000.
That is serious. That's true. Real serious. That's why I think. No, I do.
I love you, Jammer.
I think they're Jammer close over Hammer. Because I suspect that the next number will be less than that 800.
The new issue is going to mark Pamela Anderson's 14th appearance on Playboy on the cover since 1989, more than any other celebrity. So there you have it. Jose, you're a big Playboy fan, aren't you? You look at a. Yeah, kind of come see, come saw, yeah.
Why not?
So anyway. She said, she's checked first with her sons, you know, because she's getting up there. She's got sons now. She's got Brandon, 19, and Dylan, 17, before she agreed to it because the boys had been teased and made fun of and had a few fistfights over their mom. This time, both of them encouraged her to do it. She said, Anderson said she made the most of her last Playboy photo shoot. She said, quoting now, I took off all my clothes and I rolled down the hill as fast as I can. I was just screaming and my hair and boobs were flying and shoes were going everywhere. Sounds interesting. Playboy's first, you know, was the first nude posing person in Playboy? You know this answer, don't you?
Well, actually,
Double M, Marilyn Monroe. What you don't know is, you know who discovered Marilyn Monroe? President Ronald Reagan. When he was in the armed forces, he wanted to fight, but his eyesight kept him out from battle. So he was in the broadcasting division, and they had him doing films of people getting here on the mainland, putting together wartime efforts. And there was this beautiful blonde who was checking out parachutes for quality control. He said, let's put her in this, and they photographed her. And that blonde was named Norma Jean, and that was Marilyn Monroe.
I didn't know that. I knew about Joe DiMaggio, but I didn't know that about boy.
Put her in a film. He was the first one.
Wow.
It was a wartime effort.
Did not know that.
Anyway, Marilyn Monroe was on their first cover back in 1953, and they printed a nude centerfold. That photo was bought by Hefner from a printer who made calendars, and Marilyn didn't pose specifically for the magazine. That was a pre-posed nude. You're experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain, pain from a sports injury. If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low-T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the tort attorneys right now. 800-557-7921. 800-557-7921. That's 800-557-7921. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really? Mm-hmm.
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
You hear that, kid? That's the hum of a well-run facility. You know what I hate hearing? Silence. Silence on a production line means downtime. Downtime means wasted time. Wasted time means wasted money. Silence isn't golden, kid. It's deadly. That's why I love Grainger. With a wide variety of the latest products, Grainger gets us what we need when we need it to help keep this place up and running and humming away. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com or stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
The best show in the world is Two Scorpions and a Brandy Glass. I'm Barry Farber. It is nice when you call and say, oh, Mr. Farber, I agree with you, but that really gets us nowhere. I want your enmity, hostility. I want your questions. Give me a call right here on The Barry Farber Show. Weekdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
PM Show Weekend Edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. Michael Horn, Scott St. James, and Jammer with the Hammer. You worked at radio, television, acting. You were a newsman on TV. You were in real life, a real-time newsman, sports reporter. You did acting. You did radio, music, and talk shows. You worked at the legendary KMPC in Los Angeles.
Yes, I
and
did.
And met former President Ronald Reagan, did you not?
That is correct.
How did that all happen? You're doing this special for Gene Autry.
Well, first of all, I had been working in St. Louis, and I was recruited and brought out here
to work at KMPC.
Yeah, I turned down the first two offers. As I've often told people, I'm glad you asked the third time.
There you go.
I'll never forget, they were asking me to come in, and they were showing me the jet helicopter and all the rest of that stuff, and just to try to, you know, this young kid,
yep,
to show them what it was like. What they didn't know was that I was using a helicopter like that in St. Louis for dates, but they didn't know that.
Excuse me.
And to this day,
that's the connection with Hugh Hefner, I'm sure. Go ahead.
Well, and I never went public with that. But anyway, I came
until today.
Right, that's true. First time.
Hold on a second. We got somebody from St. Louis. What station did you work at?
KMOX.
KMOX.
Yeah,
on the line here to talk to you.
Yeah,
some damage to the helicopter.
Well, sadly, he's passed away too. The guy that was running that.
Okay.
But when I got here, I'd been there for a couple of weeks or something like that.
Stop. How do you get dates in a helicopter? Do you take it and land it on the woman's lawn or something? I mean, how do you get dates in a helicopter? What do you do?
Okay, the situation.
You
was,
weren't the
was
pilot, the, right? You had
no
the pilot.
Of course, not. Of course not.
Did they lower a rope down and you dangle in front of the window and wave at her inside and say, "Hey, grab a hand here," and then you go back up?
I'll make it real simple. I didn't ask for this. I didn't ask for it. Things were going well. Things were going real
obviously,
well,
if you're using
and somebody came up with the idea about to taking a girl. Would you like to take a girl to this? Oh, sure, I'd love to, and then it became a habit, and so it was just really, really nice. If things weren't working, probably nothing would have worked out for me, but it just did. I never thought that was going to happen, but anyway, that's why I turned down the first two offers, because I thought, why the hell would I
get rid of my helicopter?
Why would I leave St. Louis?
And Scott went out with a lot of pilots. A lot of male pilots that he enjoyed.
But anyway.
I've just made that up. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
And I got here, and I'm here for a couple of weeks, and all of a sudden somebody walked up, and of course it wasn't Gene. It was somebody else. we want to put together a special about Gene Autry. They thought he was going to die real soon. So
so you come out to work at KMBC where the owner possibly is going to pass away, and they tell you to do a special on him.
Well,
the great legendary Gene Autry.
No, he didn't say it.
No, I know. He said that.
He didn't say it.
Was it his doctor?
Huh?
Was it his doctor? It's serious. Just the staff.
It was somebody. And so
a doctor comes in and said, "Hey, would you do a special on Gene?" If I'm Gene, I get pretty nervous.
But this is where I was going with it. When they came to me and said, "Put the thing together," and I'm starting to put stuff together, and all of a sudden I'm thinking, and I've got all these stars on KMPC. There were a lot of big names.
Roger Carroll, come on, the RC, Gary Owens, Jeff Edwards, Dick Whittinghill, come on, Ira Cook,
every one of them,
Johnny Grant,
every one of them,
Johnny Magnus,
absolutely, everyone's
on. Clark Race, Jack Angel, just name a few of them on there.
And for whatever reason,
Bill Stewart, keep going.
I couldn't figure out why were they asking me, but
Jim Lang.
I'm a new guy. I'm not going to argue with anybody about this. And so now we're putting together
Sonny Melendres.
We got it all put together. We got it put together.
So you're doing this special,
and
you're interviewing celebrities.
How's
the Reagan connection?
7-hour thing. Well, he was one of many, but...
was he nice?
Very, very, very nice. Very nice.
Well, I'd like to sit down with you and talk to you, Scott.
Well...
I understand. Well, you're the jammer with the, well, hammer.
Well, this was just...
There you go again.
This was just before he was all set to talk to every major news guy in the world.
Yes, I am.
And he stopped everything to just do this thing for the Autry thing.
Mr. Jammer, tear down that wall.
That's pretty much what happened.
Yeah, there you go.
What a great president. We need someone like that. He was a great guy.
Loved it.
Mark Zuckerberg is in the news. He's explaining why he didn't give his Facebook billions to charity. First off, you know, this Facebook, good, bad, or indifferent, if these freaking ISIS idiots are using this thing to go ahead and... if you're stupid enough to get involved with a group like ISIS, then, you know, you need your head examined. Nothing in life can be that bad to be with these idiots. Anyway, Mark Zuckerberg made the surprise announcement. By the way, that's what they say they recruited on Facebook for this most recent
thing. I have nothing to do with that.
Anyway, I'm glad I say that. Mark Zuckerberg made the surprise announcement that he, along with his wife, Priscilla Chan, they're going to donate 99% of their Facebook shares, worth about $45 billion, to causes of advancing human potential and promoting equality. And the gesture appeared nice, but then he's been criticized. Many have said, by the way, he's using the money, giving it to a limited liability company rather than a charitable foundation. And he's explained, Zuckerberg responded to those complaints, posting another message that attempts to explain why he set up the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative. It's structured as an LLC rather than a traditional foundation, he says. This enables us to pursue our missions by funding nonprofit organizations, making private investments, and participating in policy debates. Who cares? It's his money. He can do with it what he wants, so I don't care who's complaining about this. Stick your head where the sun don't shine. It's his money. If that's what he wants to do with it, he earned it. It's his. All right?
I agree with that, but what I don't understand is why so much people spend so much time fiddling around with this.
Yeah.
I think it's a waste of time, but that's just me.
Coldplay is going to headline at the Super Bowl at the Super Bowl 50. That's going to be a big one at the halftime show.
Yep.
So it should be kind of interesting. And then sad news a little bit. We had the guy from Stone, Stone Temple Pilots. He passed away. Scott Whelan. It was Stone Temple Pilots and Velvet Revolver, and apparently had substance abuse. And everybody's going, this is terrible. It's terrible for his family that he's dead. But if you got substance abuse, hey, this is what you were heading for. This was your deal. You know, you had substance abuse. You were drinking too much. You found a way to structure your life around it and came to grips with it, you know?
It just stopped.
And it's like
March
these people are saying, all the musicians are all in support of him. In support of him, he was a freaking drug addict. This is what happens when you're a drug addict. I'm surprised he didn't croak sooner, for God's sakes.
Not alone.
Robert Loggia is dead at 85.
I love that guy.
He was THC.
I was a big fan of that guy. Every time I would see he was going to show up on the screen, I watched.
Remember he was in Scarface?
Very
big
good.
Drug kingpin.
Very, very good actor.
Anyway, it's... He was struggling with Alzheimer's for the last 5 years, and that's
that
sad.
Happens to a lot of people.
And that's something you can't really control.
It happens to a
you
lot
know,
of people.
Drugs you can control. It's a choice that you make in your life. So anyway, Robert Loggia, great actor.
Yes.
Sorry to see he's his passing. All right, we continue straight ahead. Stay with us here on CRN. It is the PM show. This is the weekend edition. I'm Michael Horn. That is Scott St. James on CRN, the controversial radio network.
Do you have really pure water? Maybe not if you're drinking bottled water. Bottled water has some dirty little secrets. Plastic bottles come from oil products. The 5-gallon polycarbonate jugs contain bisphenol A, a synthetic estrogen that has raised health concerns. Bottled water dispensers quickly develop algae and bacteria and should be sanitized regularly. Have you ever cleaned your water dispenser? Are you drinking water containing algae and bacteria and synthetic estrogen? Now the good news. Pure Water Science can replace that dirty, outdated bottled water cooler with a high-tech water purification system. The Pure Water Science system features a stainless steel tank that constantly monitors water quality to guarantee your water is pure. It alerts you when service or filter changes are needed. Multi-stage purification removes organic and inorganic contaminants, and the patented self-sanitizing feature eliminates algae and bacteria while adding oxygen to your water. It costs less than bottled water without the bottled water hassle. No more bottles to lift. Just sanitize delicious water, hot or cold, from Pure Water Science. Call 818-502-4191. 818-502-4191.
Are you worried about losing your home to foreclosure? If you've been threatened with foreclosure or receive legal papers from your bank, you have approximately 30 days to respond. If you do not respond, you could lose your home. You have rights. Act now to protect your rights. You can stay in your home. Many times you can even modify your loan. The bottom line is you can get past this, but you must act right now. If you've been served by your bank and you're worried about losing your home to foreclosure, now is the time to fight back and save your home. Time is limited, so call the professionals at National Foreclosure Defense right now.
800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. 800-515-6309. That number again is 800-515-6309.
Welcome back here to the PM show. Weekend edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, along with legendary jammer with the hammer, Scotty St. James. So Amy Schumer, Tracy Morgan, they've made Barbara Walters 2015's Most Fascinating People list. Barbara's going to do another Most Fascinating People of 2015.
Those things are good.
They are good, but yeah, sometimes she chooses the wrong people. Tracy Morgan, okay, he came back after a tragedy and that accident that he had there. His friend died in that whole crash and everything, and he's back. And Amy Schumer continues her gangbuster year.
She's hot.
She's hot.
Right
she's doing
now,
some
anyway.
Stuff, and so she's been doing well. And she's related. Is she like is... Is she the daughter of Chuck Schumer? You know, so it's the cousin of Senator Chuck Schumer. So anyway, it's interesting. And she is going to start a gun control initiative in hopes of preventing future mass shooting attacks. She's one of these nutcases that thinks limiting guns is going to stop the idiots that want to get guns to do it. You know, stick to your acting, Amy, and quit trying to go ahead and change the Constitution. Want to change the Constitution? write to your senators and put something in and get something going in Congress. That's what I got to say. I join you in that one if you want to do it. But in this Ronda Rousey, she's going to be also interviewed on this deal. She lost in that Ultimate Championship fighting over there.
She's going to do it again.
Yeah, some people, they don't know why. I think she had too many Carl's Jr. hamburgers in that commercial that she did. I think that was it. Kind of made it a little lethargic. Jennifer Lawrence is going to be in it. Now, why they wouldn't have Donald Trump on there, that's one of the most interesting candidates. Ben Carson, these guys. I don't know, but, you know, maybe Barbara doesn't want to do anything like that. She's going to have Bernie Sanders, I think.
Or he might have turned it down.
Could have. But Bernie Sanders? Bernie Sanders sounds like he works for a construction company. It's just I can't get behind him. I'll bring in Bernie Sanders. He'll get it sounded down for you. Thank you. I think he was on the contract as it worked in my house, Bernie Sanders. Hi, we have the very best people. I'll take care of your furniture for you. It's Bernie Sanders and Company. The Bernie Sanders.
Fox has got a new Rambo TV series that Sylvester Stallone is not going to act in. You're telling me here Scott St. James is going to produce it. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Yeah, he's a one-hour drama series based on Rambo. And it's, you know, he's got those Rocky movies. They always joke that there's going to be 9,000 Rockies. He's making, you know, one every few years.
Well, he has a film out right now.
Yeah.
And
have you seen it? You're a big movie.
I have not. I haven't seen it yet.
Have you seen Bond yet?
I'm going to. You know, it's funny, I haven't seen that yet. I don't know why.
Well, you're going to be disappointed when you see it.
Oh, you didn't like it?
I just don't like him. I think he's too dull.
Okay.
He plays it too serious and too negative and too dull and too dark and dank, and it's not the old James Bond that just can do everything.
Well, the Stallone thing I plan to see on
I'm going
to
see
on,
that.
On Monday.
That'll be good because Stallone will play fine. It'll be good. I might join you. Go to that new theater I told you about. You can get tickets for $1.50. You been there yet, Tomas? Telling you, right there in the Valley Plaza, $1.50. Just bring your own saran wrap to cover the seat, and you'll be fine. The lights in the theater are dark when you go in, and I'm just wondering why that is. And I'm thinking, you know, maybe a cat was here, and there's a problem.
You put that out, there'll be 10,000 people who show up.
Well, I think it's normally $3, but on the bargain days, it's $1.50.
Wow.
Kevin Bacon's going to dig into his roots for a new Tremor TV series.
Very good actor.
He is good. But I didn't like that last series he was in where there were people getting knifed all the time. It was just too gruesome.
Well, I watched
too
it.
Gruesome.
I watched it.
The whole thing, yeah, I couldn't after the first thing. Season. I thought, that's it. I'm
well,
done.
That bothers a lot of people.
It does.
I hung with it.
The 1990 comedy, creature comedy, Tremors, that franchise that they started with that has continued on and on. Kevin Bacon moved on to bigger projects, but now he could be headed back to Perfection, Nevada for another battle with the monstrous man-eating worms lurking beneath the dirt. I think that would be interesting. The man-eating worms lurking beneath the dirt. And you can check this out. Anyway, well, it's called Tremors.
The way you've described it, you got my attention, I'll tell you that.
It's true. They, you know, it's a lot of things, a lot of weird things in the news today, too. For example, there was a court case or something that was going on, and a black cat was wheeled into the courthouse to keep the nervous owner calm. You know, and so the black cat had the day in court. The judge allowed him to accompany his nervous owner into the courtroom. Taylor, of a notoriously unlucky color, my dog used to be named Taylor, sat in a shopping cart to help keep this 72-year-old guy, Aiden Wilshire, calm. Now, I've seen these things where they have animals that are calming animals. I think it's a bunch of BS. Let me tell you this. If I wheeled my black cat into the studio today, everybody would be shaken up because my poor black cat died last night. Poor little Tommy, like 18 or 20 years old, been around forever, and was having a tough day. And I came home, and he just went up to the big cat grave in the sky. And that's unnerving when you go to say, hi, little kitty, and you realize the kitty's no longer with us. So, old age. Just old age. That's unbelievable, isn't it? A cat that would be 18 or 20 years of age? Is it 7 years? Is that cat life? Is that what it is? 20 years of age, that's 240 years of age. If that cat, if I'm anything like that cat, I might have a nice long longevity there, 240 years.
The first thing you bring up when you talk about a cat being put in the courthouse, I'd wonder... The guy that's in there with the cat, I'm assuming that's not a bad guy. If it is a bad guy, you shouldn't be having an animal with him.
Well, this guy, he faced stalking charges, so that tells you he's nuts.
Yeah.
If he's got a cat to calm him down, I say he's guilty. If I'm on that jury,
really?
And you bring a cat in, I'm going to say the guy's nuts. He's nuts.
For hopers.
If you can't keep yourself calm and need a cat to do it, come on.
Really?
I mean, come on. He repeatedly, the cat, I guess not the not the guy, the defendant, popped his head out of the cart. Maybe the guy was in the cart and the cat was sitting there in the
Could
chair.
Be.
I don't know.
Could be.
But we'll have more on this as we continue.
Of course
straight.
We've got to
see what the verdict is. CRN travelers, relax at the beautiful Fountain Grove Inn and Conference Center in Santa Rosa, California. Come to quality and come to luxury. Experience the newly renovated guest rooms. They're generously sized and they're decorated in the Tuscan tradition. They have great, incredible pillow top mattresses, luxurious linens, and down-fill comforters. The Found Grove Inn also offers complimentary Wi-Fi and internet access. There's warm cookies and coffee every evening in the hotel lobby, and you can visit the newly remodeled Equus Restaurant and Equus Lounge with its new wine bar. It's the ideal place to relax and enjoy a glass of wine, and watch our What's Cooking on Wine show on CRN with host Larry Van Alst on Wednesdays. It's the Fountain Grove Inn, Hotel, and Conference Center, located in the heart of Sonoma wine country. It's easily located in Santa Rosa, off the 101 Fountain Grove Parkway exit. Call 707-578-6101. That's 707-578-6101, or visit fountaingroveinn.com.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone, like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Really? Mm-hmm. They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
Are you nearing eligibility for Medicare benefits? Then you know now is an important time in your life. Medicare benefits can be a complicated puzzle. You don't want to overpay for your Medicare coverage or get the wrong plan. Let Health Markets Insurance Agency help you. With one free phone call, a licensed insurance agent will help you select a Medicare plan that's right for you and your budget. If you're becoming eligible for Medicare, call today and learn how to get the most out of your benefits.
800-793-1960, 800-793-1960.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA or assumed name of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc., which is an authorized insurance agency in all 50 states and the District of Columbia. Not all agents are licensed to sell all products. Service and product availability varies by state.
Call 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960.
Welcome back here to the PM Show Weekend Edition on CRN. I'm Michael Horn, along with Scott St. James. Tomas pressed the buttons. Our executive producer, Courtney Cadera. Courtney and Tomas did not know that my cat had passed away. And Tomas has done some research there for me on little Tommy. He says, the life expectancy of cats, what do you think? It's different from indoor and outdoor cats. Indoor, 12 to 18 years. Outdoor, 4 to 5. You know why they're down outdoor, 4 or 5. Some coyote coming to snack them up. That's why the longest living cat was 28 years old. Thank you, Tomas, for that research. It's very nice of you to
get that. That's good. I've never had a cat. I've had a lot of dogs, but I've never had a cat.
Dogs and cats. I had Morris, who looked like Morris the cat, and yeah. Tommy was this black cat. Morris passed away maybe 3 years ago or 4 years ago or so, but Tommy, and they were both rescues. They were wandering around lost somewhere, and I brought him in. He was named after Tom Likas. Because he had a real annoying meow, kind of like, Tom Likas, talking like, meow, meow, meow. And so I named him Tommy. It was like Tom Likas, but just Tommy for short. And Tommy was a very good kitty. It would be like a dog, would come up to you and just push his head into you and want to be petted, and was just a very affectionate cat, like a dog.
Did Likas know that?
No, and he never will. Thank you. Anyway, so
does it fits?
Meow.
Yeah.
Something's wrong. Yeah. Anyway, the cat was eating right up until like a few days ago, then kind of ate a little bit, didn't, and then obviously it was just the whole time. We could tell the cat was slowing down. Yeah. Cat was getting a little blind, you know, would stand in front of my legs and kind of move from side to side, wondering what this big stump was in front of it. Hey, that's my leg. And, you know, my big booming voice is going to go, hey, how you doing, Tommy? And jump up. So then I had to, like, kind of approach the cat, like, make sure the lights turned on first so the cat knows somebody's there so I wouldn't scare him to death with my loudmouth voice. So this black cat named Taylor gets wheeled
appealed into court. This guy, 72, his name is Aiden Wilshire, uses this cat to calm him down. This takes place, when I tell you where, you'll understand everything. Okay. England. It's always in the mother country. They got nutcases there, and this is really the Brits. Come on. So this guy, the cat supposedly popped his head in and out of the cart so the owner could pet him, and the judge was asked for permission to wheel the cat into the in Essex, in the court in Essex in southeast England to, quote, emotionally support the client, and he said it was a crutch which he relies on. And I appreciate it sounds somewhat odd, but there's documentary evidence that the cat does provide emotional support for the defendant to cope. This is why I tell you this guy is probably guilty. If he needs a cat to cope, whatever they're accusing him of, he's guilty. Anyway, the judge gave the go-ahead and even reported to have joked, quoting now, "Don't let the cat out of the bag."
Woo!
Don't let the cat out of the bag. I said, don't let the cat out of the bag. I thought we were going to get a rim shot there somewhere.
Bada bing.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Anyway, when they left the courthouse, according to the BBC, this guy is accused, this guy, Aiden Wilshire, 72, of two stalking offenses between 2013 and 2015. He has not entered a plea yet. But we're going to stay on this one if we can, because we don't want to let the cat out of the bag. I'm saying we don't want to let the cat out of the bag. Nah, it's not working.
What a thing. My sister.
Where's my cat? I don't care if the cat's dead or not. Bring it. I need to calm down.
My sister has a black cat, and that cat tends to stay under the bed. And,
well, that's where my cat is now.
Yeah,
I'm not
hard to get out.
Anyway, there'll be services for Tommy next week on the PM show. So stay tuned for that. Anyway, that's our show. We got to get out of here. Thanks so much for joining us here. Thank you, Scotty St. James.
My pleasure. My pleasure.
Thank you, Tomas. Thank you, Courtney Kadare, executive producer. Thank you for listening. Barry Farber coming up next on most of these same network stations, so stay tuned for that. Have yourselves a great weekend. Only 3 weeks before Christmas, so get that shopping done. I'm Michael Horn. Have a great night.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. Of course, you can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. But if cutting-edge technology is more your style, you'll be happy to know that CRN is now available on Wi-Fi radio. Simply log on to receiva.com. That's R-E-C-I-V-A.com, and look for CRN. You can access all of our great shows and listen live anywhere in the world. Be part of your favorite shows and get the full CRN listening experience you would have with any traditional radio, podcast, or a live stream from our website. For more information on where or how to listen, and for a full list of our programming, log on to crntalk.com and create your own listening experience today. The Radio Channel.